स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज प्रोनाउंस। ए प्रोनाउन इज यूज्ड एज ए सब्स्टिट्यूट फॉर ए नाउन और ए नाउन फ्रेज। इन अदर वर्ड्स, इट हैज ऑल द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ ए नाउन। इट कैन फंक्शन एज ए सब्जेक्ट, ऑब्जेक्ट, कॉम्प्लीमेंट इन ए सेंटेंस। प्रो मीन्स फॉर और एक्टिंग एज। ए प्रोनाउन इज यूज टू अवॉइड द रिपीटेशन ऑफ नाउन्स और नाउन फ्रेजेस, सच एज सुरेश वेंट टू द मार्केट बिकॉज सुरेश वांटेड टू बाय ए पेन। दिस सेंटेंस कैन बी अमेंडेड लाइक दिस, सुरेश वेंट टू द मार्केट बिकॉज ही वांटेड टू बाय ए पेन। वॉकिंग इज ए फॉर्म ऑफ एक्सरसाइज। वॉकिंग इज ईजियर देन स्विमिंग। वी कैन से दिस सेंटेंस, वॉकिंग इज ए फॉर्म ऑफ एक्सरसाइज, इट इज ईजियर देन स्विमिंग। बट ए प्रोनाउन इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम ए नाउन इन दैट इट कैन नॉट टेक ए प्री मॉडिफाइंग एडजेक्टिव, नॉर कैन इट टेक ए डिटर्मिनर और प्रीफिक्स सफिक्स। द फॉर्म ऑफ ए प्रोनाउन इज फिक्स्ड। काइंड्स ऑफ प्रोनाउंस। देर आर 9 काइंड्स ऑफ प्रोनाउंस। पर्सनल प्रोनाउंस, पसेसिव प्रोनाउंस, रेसिप्रोकल प्रोनाउंस, डेमोस्ट्रेटिव प्रोनाउंस, रिफ्लेक्टिव प्रोनाउंस, एम्फेटिक प्रोनाउंस, रिलेटिव प्रोनाउंस, इंट्रोगेटिव प्रोनाउंस, इंडेफिनेट प्रोनाउंस। पर्सनल प्रोनाउंस। आई, वी, यू, ही, सी, इट, दे। दीज 7 प्रोनाउंस आर कॉल्ड पर्सनल प्रोनाउंस। On the basis of their role in a speech, these can be divided into 3. First person, second person, and third person. I, we, first person, you, second person, he, she, it, they, third person. पसेसिव प्रोनाउन। माई, आवर, योर, हिज, हर, देयर, इट्स। माइन, आवर्स, योर्स, हिज, हर्स, देयर्स, इट्स। दे आर यूज टू एक्सप्रेस ओनरशिप, पोजीशन, रिलेशनशिप। डिटर्मिनर्स आर फॉलोड बाय ए नाउन। दिस इज माय रूम। द पोजेसिव प्रोनाउन इन इट्स प्रेडिकेटिव यूज कैन नॉट बी फॉलोड बाय ए नाउन। वी डोंट से दिस इज माय रूम, वी से द रूम इज माइन। इट इज ऑलवेज यूज्ड एज ए डिटर्मिनर, नेवर एज ए प्रेडिकेटिव। दिस इज ए लॉक एंड दैट इज इट्स की, नॉट दैट की इज इट्स। रेसिप्रोकल प्रोनाउंस। ईच, अदर, वन अनदर। दीज आर यूज टू एक्सप्रेस म्यूचुअल रिलेशनशिप। They love each other, one another. In a traditional grammar, In traditional grammar, a distinction between each other and one another. It requires that each other be used of only two people, things, and one another of more than two. In current English, both are used interchangeably with a slight preference for each other. For example, the children can help each other in doing the homework. Demonstrative pronouns: this, that, these, those. They are used to point to people or things they stand for, such as, this is our house, that is the bridge built by the British. Demonstrative pronouns have numbered contrast: this, these, that, those. This for singular, these for plural, that singular, those plural. The basic function of demonstratives is to indicate the nearness or distance of the person or object referred to from the speaker. Some of the uses of demonstrative pronouns are: when pointing, this is my brother Ravi, that is his new car. When a specific category is implied, those who apply late will not be considered. When there is a reference to a previous statement or a statement that follows, this is what I told them, that is my question on the matter. Difference between it and this: it is a personal pronoun, but this is a demonstrative pronoun. As a demonstrative pronoun, this indicates nearness and also identifies a person or thing. The use of it does not convey these shades of meaning, so this is preferred to it for making a formal announcement or introduction. This is All India Radio giving you the news. This is Jaya, my friend. In an answer, however, it is preferred to this when a contracted form is used. What is this? It is a new electronic device. But when a contracted form is not used, this is okay. What is this? This is a new electronic device. Reflexive pronouns form: a reflexive pronoun is formed by attaching selves to the objective form of the pronoun. For example, myself, ourselves, yourself, yourselves, himself, herself, themselves, itself. A reflexive pronoun is used as a substitute for a noun in the objective case as a direct object. Suppose there is a sentence: Govind saw Govind in the mirror. We use this sentence like this: Govind saw himself in the mirror. This is used to avoid an awkward construction: Govind, Govind. Gayatri laughed at Gayatri. We can modify this sentence, Gayatri laughed at herself. So we can avoid an awkward situation by using reflexive pronouns. Reflexive means bent back, bending the subject back to the subject. A reflexive pronoun is used when the subject and the object refer to the same person or thing. This can be seen from the agreement between the subject and the reflexive object. I saw myself in the mirror. We dressed ourselves in the kitchen. You sent yourself a birthday card. They wrote themselves a thank you note. He hurt himself while playing. She taught herself the piano. One should avail oneself on this chance. It can be used as an indirect object as well. Sujata made herself a new dress. A reflexive pronoun can be used as a subject complement too. He is never himself. You don't look quite yourself today. Like the reciprocal pronoun, each other, reflexive pronouns too need an antecedent in the sentence so that they cannot occur as the subject of the main clause. For example, you should cook your food yourself. Some verbs always take a reflexive pronoun as object. He absented himself from the meeting. You ought to avail yourself of this opportunity. Sushma prides herself on her painting. In American English, avail usually occurs without a reflexive pronoun, but not in British. Adjust, address, behave, conduct, enjoy, all take a reflexive object. He has acquitted himself well as manager. She adapted herself to new conditions. I cannot adjust myself to these changes. We enjoyed ourselves last week. Emphatic pronouns. Emphatic pronouns are used for emphasis. They have forms identical to those of reflexive pronouns, but their function is different. Mary himself typed all the letters. Subject emphasized. Alternatively, the emphatic pronoun can come at the end, after the object. Mary typed all the letters herself. I saw the queen herself, object emphasized. I spoke to the queen herself, object of the preposition emphasized. An emphatic pronoun can be used to emphasize an expression of time or place as well. This work can be finished today itself. What is the need to go abroad? One can do quality research here itself. Relative pronouns. Who, whom, which, what, that. A relative pronoun relates or refers back to a noun or pronoun. called its antecedent. It also joins clauses, so it is a pronoun as well as a conjunction. Relative pronouns introduce relative clauses and noun clauses. Those who live in glass houses should not throw stones. I don't know who is standing at the gate. These are the examples, which is used also as a sentence relative pronoun to introduce the relative clause in a sentence. They eat snakes, which is unusual. Interrogative pronouns: who, whom, whose, which, what. The forms of relative pronouns and interrogative pronouns are identical, but their function are different. The former join clauses, the latter ask questions. Who can come as the subject or as the object in a clause? Here who refers only to persons, not to things. Who discovered America as subject? Who did you invite for lunch as object? Who are you talking about as object of the preposition? In current English, whom is rarely used as the object. Who is the preferred form? Whose is the possessive form of who? It can stand for both animate and inanimate nouns in interrogative expressions. For example, do you know whose book won the award this year? Refers to the author. I borrowed a book from the library whose pages are all torn. Refers to book. Which is used for both people and things when there is an implied choice or selection. Which card game do you like to play? Which teacher do you like best? What as subject or object is used to refer the things only, such as what is in your pocket, what is wrong with you. Who is used for asking questions about a person's name? What for seeking information about a person's profession? For example, who is that gentleman talking to your father? The answer is, he is Mr. Mohan. What is he? Now we have to answer about his profession, and we say he is an artist. Which presupposes a set and the person is being asked about his choice. What, on the other hand, does not presuppose any set and there is no choice implied. For example, which do you want? The red one. What do you want? Some coffee. Emphatic interrogative pronouns: ever placed after interrogatives, who, what, which makes a question emphatic and expresses anger, surprise, annoyance, etc. These journalists, whoever do they think they are. Whatever do you mean? Note that ever is written as a separate word, whoever. In such constructions, ever is used as a substitute for harsh and impolite expressions like on earth, the devil, the hell, the deacons, the places. Where the deacons were you, I have been waiting almost an hour. What the hell were the police doing when the riots started? These are quite common in speech, but not recommended in formal writing. Instead, we say, whatever were the police doing when the riots started. Else, another word that combines with who or what and gives its emphasis is else. This structure often makes the question rhetorical, which else is extremely rare. What else can the students do? They cannot do anything now. Who else is going to listen to us? No one is going to listen us. Now we speak about indefinite pronouns. Indefinite pronouns constitute one can go constitute heterogeneous set. One can go about classifying them differently using different criteria. Universal pronouns. Each refers to two or more people or things, whereas every refers to three or more. Further, each presupposes a set, every does not. For example, Rajiv walked into the room and gave a sweet to everyone, not each. But each and every take all constructions following them, so does all. All can occur immediately before a noun. Therefore, it is more like a determiner. At times, a definite article can intervene between all and the noun. All the girls want to imitate Karen. Each of you should attend the function. Every one of them came to see me in hospital. Assertive pronouns. There are five subclasses in this. Much, many, more, most. Much goes with uncountable nouns, whereas many goes with countable nouns. More and most can be used with both uncountable and uncountable nouns. For example, much milk, most milk. Many heads, more heads, most heads. Little less, least, few, fewer, fewest. Less goes with uncountable nouns and fewer with countable nouns. Occasionally, less can be found with count nouns too. Expressions denoting periods of time, sums of money, etc. take less. For example, there is less orange juice in my glass. There are fewer public holidays this year. Several, enough. Several occurs with plural countable nouns only. Enough can occur with both countable and uncountable nouns. Enough, unlike several, can precede or follow the head noun. For example, Hanif and I met and spoke to several craft persons at the fair. Have you packed enough food for a day? Have you packed food enough for a day? 1. The use of one as a pronoun is typical of British English. In American English, his is used in place of one's. One should love one's neighbor. One should not think too much of oneself. In question text, we, you is preferred to repeating one. One cannot live all alone. Can we? Can you? One once can substitute for a countable noun. This mirror has cracked. It needed to buy a new one. These grapes are sour. I like sweet ones. Someone, somebody, something. Some usually goes with positive statements, questions. Something must be done before it is too late. Can someone help me with accounts? I hope somebody picks up the phone. Non-assertive pronouns. Anyone, anybody, anything. Any, unlike some, has some special occurrence properties. It does not occur with positive statements unless there is a modal element like can or will. A negative also can license any. The citizens will not believe anything, not the citizens believe anything. I cannot challenge anybody. Either. Either as a pronoun refers to one out of a set of two. Note that either is always singular. Either you make up your mind quickly or we leave you and go. Either of the two proposals is acceptable to me. Negative pronouns. No, no one, nobody, none, nothing. No can precede a noun, therefore it is like a determiner. Madhuri showed no interest in the new film. The rest of the N series have only normal function. These generally take an affirmative verb. They do not allow a note in the sentence. For example, the police did nothing to control the mob. We can't say this, the police could not do nothing. There are certain varieties of non-standard English where a double negative is common. Neither. Neither in the negative counterpart of either. It is always used in singular. It can come before a noun. Neither of the allegations is true. Neither allegation is true. Distributive pronouns. Distributive pronouns or distributives constitute a set which overlaps with the classes of pronouns sets up so far. Distributives are so called because they refer to the whole amount or the separate items, each, every, either, neither. Words like half and whole are also treated as distributive, though they can hardly be taken as pronouns. Like nouns, pronouns too have number, but the number system of pronoun is different from that of nouns, because as s is not added to pronoun to turn them into plural, the singular and plural forms of pronouns are fixed. Singular forms: I, me, my, mine, myself. Plural: we, us, our, ours, ourselves. Singular: you, your, yours, yourself. Plural: you, your, yours, yourself. Singular: he, his, him, himself. She, her, hers, herself. It, its, itself, oneself. Plural: they, them, their, theirs, themselves. This, that, much, little. Plural: these, those, ones, both, many, some. In this way, pronouns have their plurals. Gender. So far as gender is concerned, pronoun genders are of four kinds. Gender are of four kinds: masculine, feminine, common, and neutral. The gender system of pronouns is different from that of nouns, because a suffix like ews is not used to make a gender distinction. The gender of pronouns is fixed. Masculine pronouns: he, him, his, himself. Feminine pronouns: she, her, hers, herself. Common gender pronouns: I, we, you, they. Mine, ours, yours, theirs. Myself, yourself, ourselves, themselves. Each, other, one another. Each, either, neither. In this way, the gender pronouns are also fixed. In this way, we have discussed the whole system of pronouns, and I think my video will be useful for you.